So right now I got this thing going here. It's a long canvas. I don't know. It's about this is just an offcut from another piece of canvas I cut and stretched. This one I'm just painting unstretched. It's painting loose, and it's kind of like a what do I call it? It's kind of like a Last Supper thing, the 12 plus one. But we've got these people. I don't know. I got to add eyes and nose and teeth, and there's the guy. And yeah, so whatever's going on with this, I really don't know. But I did the whole background in acrylics, and then to get the costumes, the robes done in, I did those in acrylics. But the rest, all the flesh tones and the hair and at this point, everything else, the facial features and lining out, shading and stuff, that's all gonna be in oils. So this is a fun one. Let's see what happens when it's all done and dry. I'll roll it up and do something else. It's pretty fun though. I'm enjoying it. This I have to wait. There's still a lot of wet paint. So I have to wait for it to dry before I can do anything else. So I've got another piece of loose canvas that's about almost 4 by 6 feet that I'm going to just do a quick spontaneous sketch on and paint it up. Some more figurative stuff. Play around with that with goofiness and irreverence and all that stuff. So hold on for a minute while I get the camera set up on my next painting, and I'll show you what's happening with that. I think I'll do like a chronicle the sketching out and drawing of it. It's like I said, going to be really wild, spontaneous, poof, no reference material, crap like that. So see you in a minute. Okay, so here we are. That's what I'm using. It's an oil stick. It's not a pastel because pastels are made with oils that do not dry. This is made with oils that do dry, so it's a pretty cool product. Totally compatible with regular oil paints or whatever, all oil paints, and goes on real nice. It dries usually much quicker than oil paints. That's a black. Blacks can take like 5 days to dry if you do the brush on out of the tube kind of thing with mediums, but this is real fast, so it's a good way to get a sketch down and see what you're doing. So what I need to do is I need to do a party portrait. That's what this is. There's going to be four, five, six people. I'll see what happens. I already know my idea. The people in the front, it's a couple of girls getting goofy. So yeah, start drawing. So you can see how this stuff kind of lays itself down. Allows for a real spontaneous look, and accuracy isn't important because as far as layout goes it is, but as far as details go, accuracy isn't important because all this stuff can be painted over. So that's pretty fun. Got some hair, pull eyebrows. Eyeballs, not eyeballs, eyelids. Let's get a couple of eyes in there. Nose. Okay, pretty straightforward. Just full on, full facial, full portrait. That's gotta stop there. Need a hand, need a hand, need a shoulder. It's gonna come back up. Let's get some hips in there. Other side of the face. Down there. I hope I'm talking loud enough for y'all.
I'll show you a close up when this is all done. We got a little yellow playing in the background. Don't know if you guys like yellow. Maybe you like green better. The only green I know of is Green Day. But anyway, this is kind of like where I've been taking my art for a long time. I learned through doing the surf art that really what I enjoyed doing was the figures, the people on the surfboards, and playing with anatomy, breaking all the rules. So once I realized that, the arena I was working in really opened up, because now I can put people doing anything I want. They don't have to be surfing. And I'm much more free. Yeah, flips. Now you can tell I'm going to put something there. It's going to be a finger. Let's come down. And down. Down. There. Now, four fingers. Not that she needs them. I could just as easily do three fingers or six fingers. People don't need to have five fingers and a thumb. Nobody says that. Well, some people say it, but I don't. I'm not a supporter of reality. I mean, obviously, being we've got this corona thing happening. Reality isn't the funnest thing. My reality is not changed a whole lot. I'm still isolated in my little cave here. That's an artist's life. Spend most of the time alone. But what is kind of challenging is that I'm going to run out of materials. I think we've got another 4 or 5 weeks of so-called confinement. And I don't know if I can get materials. It seems that shipping and postal stuff and all that kind of sketchy. So anyway, talk about sketchy. Let's bring this. Back to the people, that's more important. How's that going? Yeah, it's going. Okay, we're getting there. Once more people up here. Okay, do I go to symmetry? I'll start with symmetry. I'll have a triad. Need a head right up here. Nondescript at this point, but that's a background figure. I'm gonna end up getting goofy with it, I'm sure. You guys can always count on me getting goofy. Another face. So now I'm going off symmetry a bit, which is good. Being fixed and stuck. Stuck is and not the most pleasurable thing. There's another face. See, so what we've got going here is a party portrait. I don't know whose party it is, though. But it is a party. Yes, it is. Okay, let's do a real pointy head here. I have something really disturbing. This guy, I've really got to disturb his reality. Yeah. Get more of this peel off. These sticks, they get a skin on them because the surface dries. And they can get kind of messy. Let's open up the skin. Easiest thing to deal with. Kind of fussy and bothersome. But it's a good product. Just look for oil sticks. There's, if you're interested in this kind of thing. I'm not going to do any product placement. Because the four or five brands that do these, are all pretty reliable. Yeah. What I've done is I've cut off a chunk so I have a nice point. Of course, my hands are a mess now. But once I have that point, I can work it down, and then I'll take that other pigment and I'll just stick it back on the end. But right now, gotta get your hands in, gotta get dirty. Yep. Okay, I wanna do the body first here. The guy in a t-shirt. T-shirts are great. Just love t-shirts. So easy to draw. Here's a bell. Okay, got the belt. That's his waist. Belt's a bit high. Okay, we play with it. Here's his pants. A nice long body, nice long head, and a very short torso. That's good shit. Oh, I like that. What's he doing? What's he doing? He's being weird. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, there's a general rule that it's just a kind of a foundational thing that you got to be really careful with even numbers. And I've got this big space over here. I currently have 5 individuals, so I could put 2 more in here. There's a room. But it's not all about using every inch you got. Sometimes it's about leaving space. So if I just throw one more in there, if I just throw one more figure in, I've got 6, and that's kind of like a I don't know if I like that. But if I just put one over there and leave a lot of space, then I'm implying the room. There's the space for another figure. So I'm gonna go with that and see what happens. Where do I put the head? Okay. Head. Let's just do this in one shot. See, so that's a head. You see how you do heads? That's what they teach you in college. Yep. Basically, you could spend 6 hours doing somebody's head, or you can do it in 5 seconds. I prefer the 5 seconds. So, get the arm down here. What she's doing, I don't know. Get the hips, the waist. Let's get the hair. Yeah, those are ears. That'll work. So, yeah, they'll have pupils. And everybody has eyelids, except this one. She don't need eyelids. She's doing good. Need a little line in here. So there we have it. It's about 5 feet, four by six, something like that. I haven't measured it. I just kind of whacked it off the roll. So anyway, you can see none of them have their eyeballs, but they have their eyelids.